One of the most memorial events in one's life might be your first knife. A man at that stage doesn't need much more than a good old Bowie knife. But as you journey on through the trials of knife use, you might find that the knife you picked might not have been the ideal knife for the job. Many knives can be linked to a use through their characteristics. Bushcraft knives often have a scandy grind, a functional handle and a simple design. Survival knives tend to be very sturdy, have a carefree handle, convex grind and reliable carefree sheath. Combat knives mostly have baked guards, are pointy shaped for stabbing and are often coated black to prevent reflections. But it don't take much for a man to be deceived by looks. One knife in particular, the very popular, annoyingly much requested TBS.
DBK, giveaway, TRC, Apocalypse and Cold Steel, SR1, oh my god, more than $800,
Oeh, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, de episode is echt al begonnen ook.
Ja. Wow. We have a very special knife that has been requested a lot by you people.
Yeah.
It is, Mickey,
the TBS Boar.
And look how fat it is, just as fat as a boar. We tried making a video about this a few years back, Mickey.
Yeah.
But we just really didn't like the knife.
No.
So we canceled that episode.
Yeah.
That's what we did back then. And now it's time to share the truth about this knife with all of you.
Now,
so Maarten,
If I understand correctly, my only function in this starting shot was just to agree with you. Like,
you should agree
with me. I'm the fact checker.
Yeah, you are. And you have an ugly face.
That's true.
No, it's not really that sharp!
Oh yeah, folks, it seemed like the DBK boys had a new problem to fix. Look at that bevel. It is too small, making the edge angle too fat in combination with the blade thickness to be able to get a crazy sharp edge. So let's see how it does with some regular bushcrafting tasks.
So good, no.
Mickey,
no.
It batons like a beast. It batons like a beast. Yeah. Because it's just a fat fuck.
Oh! I'll bleep that out. Can I have the knife, please?
Yeah, feather sticking, no. You know why? Because of that little, small, tiny ass bevel.
Yeah, and also a big problem is that the handle, ladies and gentlemen, the handle is beefy as bloody hell.
Yeah.
It has laid in the water once or got wet once.
Yeah, during sharpening. I was just sharpening the knife on my Nanua Chocera stones. I mean, I have had knives like this that didn't have this problem with curly birch handles.
Right. All joking aside, it was a scandy after all. So in theory, it should carve like a hot knife through Martin's belly fat.
I really wanted to like this knife because
yeah,
it's just
me
it's,
too.
It looks like a beast. It's like the Bushcraft version of a Becker BK2. But man, it just isn't good.
Martin, I think we should give these sexy bastards a demonstration of a knife that should cut. Martin, I think the only way we should solve this is to give these people a reference of how a good Bushcraft knife would do this.
Okay, well, back to Mickey.
It's been a long day, full of dirty looks and pretty smiles to keep the world out of harm's way. I need a soulmate, someone who knows about the ins and outs and the day-to-day of heartbreaks. I feel the cold hands that try to keep me still and try to squeeze me till I'm frozen to knowing. I know the old ways and the times that change and the fact that they would never fit together in this moment. Is it all I got? Give it more than what I think I got. This life is bigger than my one indifference. Mine is in my hands. Hold on with all I got and be strong. Be strong. Hold on. I am not the type to sit on the side.
Martin was devastated by the results. He had bought a 190 euro knife that sucked. Though not the Bushcrafter, maybe he still could use it in the kitchen.
Sorry.
The conclusion. Well, we said a lot about this knife already. I don't think we should say a lot more about this knife.
So, wait, our giveaway, ladies and gentlemen. Please visit our link in the description where we do the giveaway. Yeah. Mickey, this month we are giving away the TRC Apocalypse DBK edition. It is convex.
Check.
And we're giving the Cold Steel
SR1, one of the strongest folders.
And it is amazing as well. So it's about 600 euros in total. So like $700.
Two DBK straps. Oh, amazing. We are now announcing the giveaway winner in the video.
Anyway, the knife is probably my favorite knife of all time. It is an incredible joke, because I'm funny. I make little jokes. Okay. It is really not a knife I think you should buy.
I mean,
I don't like the grind. It is too thick and it is too steep.
I mean, the bevel line just starts here. Just gives the knife too steep angle. Doesn't really get sharp.
No.
It is just bulky. It's not controlled for Bushcraft. What else can we say? There are just a lot better options at this price point, like the Custom Lost Files. Enzo Trapper is better.
Ladies and gentlemen, we like to recommend knives, but we can't recommend this knife to you.
No.
Sorry, TBS. We're not saying it's a bad brand, per se.
No, definitely not. I mean, they have also... They also have a few other knives that might be good, we don't know, but this one is just too bulky. Don't buy it.
Yeah. Do what you should buy is everything in our shop, because you make us very happy and you make sure that
we stay alive.
Yeah.
Let's
and that would make my mother happy.